anybody who knows me knows that I am a huge Rush fan. I am a huge vinyl collector, and I do like box sets. What I wanted to do was do an unboxing of this new Rush Moving Pictures Super Deluxe box set. 5 LPs, 3 CDs, 1 Blu-ray DVD, and I believe a partridge in a pear tree. And this is the 40th anniversary box set, but it's coming out in 2022, which would actually be the 41st anniversary, but things being what they were the past couple of years, I guess there was a little bit of a hiccup. So, with that said, let's see what's going on inside this box. Now, truth be told, I opened this already yesterday when I first got it because, well, I had to. And I haven't listened to it yet. I wanted to do this unboxing first. To start it all off, there was shrink wrap on this, and there was what they call a hype sticker, which is right there. I kept the plastic. Yes, I kept the plastic. Why? Because that's just what I do. Let's take a look at the box itself. Obviously, we have this new artwork on the front. And you could see there's this film theme running around the entire box. I know that's probably out of focus. So you could see that runs around the entire box. If we take a quick look at the back, you could see there's a lot going on back there. There's a lot to talk about because there's a lot going on in this box. Without further ado, let's flip it back over again. And you hear things moving around in there, and there's a reason for that. Mind you, the box is fairly heavy, so you know there's a lot going on and it's substantial. It's also very difficult to open. It's like airtight, like NASA style. And I don't want to be too hard on it, because somebody else was already in the shipping portion of our programming. And unfortunately, as you could see right up there between the R and the U, that was done in shipping. That was not how this box set is supposed to come. There it is in all its glory. So we have this nice little band here to help you take everything out of the box. But first off, you have the actual album itself, Moving Pictures. We'll get to that second part in a minute. You can see it's all the original artwork. It comes in a plain black inner. However, all the liner notes and all the lyrics come on a separate sheet on the inside, so you're definitely not missing out on that. It's everything that came with the original Moving Pictures back in 1981. So we know what that is, one of the greatest albums, one of the greatest rock albums ever made, one of the greatest albums ever made, period. And for many Rush fans, the best album they've ever made, which I don't agree with. I think Farewell to Kings is better. That's my personal opinion, but this is still a great album. So, moving on. One thing that it does come with that I'm really super excited about is this, and it's called Rush Live in YYZ 1981, or as they would say, YYZ. So, what does that mean? Well, this was recorded live in Toronto, where they came from, and it's actually 4 LPs of live concert. Gatefolds, pretty awesome gatefolds for that matter, from that era, which if you're a Rush fan will know this was the tour that bore Exit Stage Left. Now, again, if we're looking at the inners, they just come on plain black inners, okay, with custom labels. This is a concert that basically encapsulates everything that you would find on Exit Stage Left across 4 LP. Except there's a lot more than you'll find on Exit Stage Left. Second set, again, gatefolds, the professor alone in this one. Rest in peace, Neil Peart. I was listening to some of the songs, especially YYZ, or again, as they announce it, YYZ, and the drum solo that's in it is absolutely astounding. I mean, it is just brutal in a good way. And, you know, there is some familiarity comparing it with the drum solo on Exit Stage Left and even on All the World's a Stage. But the first minute or so is very, very different, very, very strong. It's a very aggressive drum solo from Neil Peart. And that's why I really, really like it a lot. So I definitely recommend you check it out. Now, there's more. So this packet right here has a lot of goodies, starting with this Moving Pictures Rush World Tour Total Access. I don't know what it is, like a fake slate for a movie. So kind of cool. But there's a lot of other really cool things in here. There's some fake tickets from back in the day, reproductions of tickets from when they played the Maple Leaf Gardens. And as you can see, the price is $9.95. I'm sorry, $9.55. And then there was like a service fee of less than a dollar. So $10.50 to go see Rush back in 1981. Bring those prices back, please, for every band. Here we go. There's a YYZ baggage tag that I don't recommend using because while it's cool, it is cardboard and you know it'll get ruined in about 35 seconds. Then there's this. A lenticular moving pictures thing. I don't know if, yeah, you can kind of see it. It moves, literally are moving pictures. See, the pictures are moving. Therefore, moving pictures. So, kind of cool. Cool piece to have. Next up is the tour guide from that era, from that tour, from the Moving Pictures tour, along with a byline from Neil Peart. Kind of awesome. With all the credits again, there's a crossword, which I will not do, which some of the clues are actually kind of funny. So definitely check that out. But a bit on everybody, Neil, Getty, Alex, and some pictures and stuff from the tour. All right, what else do we have? We have a couple of posters. So this first one, it's a trifold with three different sets of pictures on it. So one old school, Alex Getty and John Rutsey. This one from right around that era of Moving Pictures. And a third one as well. Some new posters and photography. Pretty cool. Then there's another poster. Now this one is a promo poster from when they actually played the Maple Leaf Gardens. Also really cool. And again, identifying those really cheap ticket prices. Would have been cool to see them back then and save a whole lot of money. I think the last time I saw Rush, I paid about $175 a ticket. And so that's everything that's in there. Now, there's still some other items left. One is this right here, which is a whole book discussing the 40th anniversary of Moving Pictures. And chock full of awesomeness. Notes from the band. Biography type things. Partially written by Kim Thayil from Soundgarden. Les Claypool, Neil Sanderson from 3 Days Grace, Bill Kelleher from Mastodon, Taylor Hawkins from the late, great Taylor Hawkins from the Foo Fighters. He's in here as well. But anyway, so yeah, you get all these really cool pictures, basically the entire album in pictorial format with all the lyrics to all the songs. Really cool. 44-page booklet, hardcover book. And I'm just flipping through it quick, but lots of great pictures. And again, all the liner notes and everything else that goes along with that, with the original album credits and the 40th anniversary credits. And that's where all the CDs and the Blu-ray are. So the CDs are the same thing, mimics the albums. It's going to be Moving Pictures, the album itself. Then it's going to be those concerts, the Live in YYZ, Live from Toronto, YYZ, whatever you want to call it. And then Blu-ray, which actually has some videos and things of that nature. It actually has a video that they made for YYZ just recently, and it's an animated video that looks like it's based around like a heist and featuring all the characters from the cover of Moving Pictures. It's actually a really cool video. You could check it out on YouTube. And lastly, there are some other goodies in the bottom of the box. And what you're going to find are this Moving Pictures 40th anniversary pin, which is really substantial, pretty heavy, really cool. A Geddy Lee signed, or actually engraved, metal guitar pick. Of course, an Alex Lifeson engraved metal guitar pick. And, fantastically enough, a pair of Neil Peart signature sticks commemorating the 40th anniversary of Moving Pictures. This is really, really cool to have a pair of these sticks. I'll just put those back for now. And one last thing, this is actually really cool, is a red Barchetta. Yes, this is the car that inspired the song Red Barchetta. And you can see it right there, has the inscription. Rush Moving Pictures 40th Anniversary Red Barchetta. I don't know if I'll display outward because I do have a dog, and he will somehow get to it no matter where I put it, and it will be no longer red nor a Barchetta. It'll be Barchuda. Anyway, I thought this was pretty awesome to find in the bottom of the box there. So that's pretty much the entire box set. I hope you guys enjoyed this unboxing. If you have any comments, please put them down below. You know, tell us what your favorite Rush song was, what your favorite Rush song is, what your favorite Rush song from Moving Pictures is. For me, it's Vital Signs, personally. I'm a huge fan of that tune. But anyway, that's about it. Hope you enjoyed this. Thanks again for watching.